tell me what is the law of reflection? Law of reflection. Who will tell me? Law of reflection. Okay. Ankita Mishra, you to attend campus class, you know. Niharika Tiwari. Okay, Niharika, tell me.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
The law of reflection states the angle of reflection equals the angle of incidence.
Okay, and what is the second law of reflection? There are two laws of...
So what?
There are two laws of reflection. So you have told the one law and tell me the second, means the other law, another one.
The angle are measured relative to the perpendicular to the surface at the point where the ray strikes the surface.
Okay. Let me ask you another one. Ragini Singh. Where is Ragini Singh? Okay, Ragini, tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Huh.
Sir, the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal lie in the same plane at the point of incidence.
Okay. That's good. Okay. So there are two laws of reflection. What is the first law? That angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. Okay. And the second law, the reflected ray, incident ray, and the normal lie in the same plane. Means that suppose this is XY plane, this board, and we can draw all the rays in same plane. So what we can say, the incident ray, the normal, and the reflected ray lie in the same plane. Now we will study about mirror and formation of image by mirror, plane mirror. So I have told you, we will denote plane mirror like this. Okay. So when we draw any letter, suppose this is L, and we place the letter L in front of plane mirror. So how the image is formed? Like this. Okay. When we raise our left hand in front of mirror, so we can see our right hand is raised. Okay. So when we write letter A, how it is formed? Like this. When we write B, how it is formed in image of B in mirror? Like this. And when we write Z, how it is formed? Like this. Okay. So this phenomena is called lateral inversion. Means the object laterally inverted in the image of plane mirror. Okay. So the phenomena due to which the left hand side of an object appear as the right hand side and vice versa is called lateral inversion. Okay. So all images in a plane mirror are laterally inverted. So you have observed that on ambulance, all the letters, spelling of ambulance, letters of ambulance is written laterally inverted. Why it is written laterally inverted? So that if it is behind any vehicle, suppose car or truck, and in the side mirror, if the vehicle see the image, means the correct image of the ambulance, suppose it is written like this, MAMBULANCE. Okay. That's how it is written on the ambulance. But when we drive a car or bike and see in a rear, means its side mirror, so it will be seen like this. Ambulance. MBULANCE. Okay. So we can easily read it and give a pass to the ambulance. Why? Because there may be some patient in ambulance who have to go soon as to the doctor. Okay. So this concept is called lateral inversion. Now we will see how the formation of image in a plane mirror. Okay. Ankit Singh and Sachin Singh, if you have no doubt, you can lower your hand. Sachin Singh and Ankit Singh. Suppose This is a plane mirror. Okay. And object is kept here. And this is called coated surface and this is called reflected surface. Okay. So what happens? A light ray will pass. Okay. Another light will fall on the reflecting surface. And what happens? It will reflect. Suppose this is a normal of this surface and this is a normal. So it will reflect same angle at same angle, means this is angle of incidence. So it will be reflected like this and reflected like this. So image is formed like here. Okay. So I'm going to tell you the properties of image formed or the characteristics of image formed by the plane mirror. See. This is a plane mirror. Okay. And suppose you are standing in front of plane mirror. Okay. And where is your image formed? Behind the mirror, or we can say inside the mirror. So the characteristics of image formed by the plane mirror is first one. The distance of object is equal to the distance of image. Means when we stand 2 meters away from the plane mirror, suppose this distance is 2 meters. So the image is formed 2 meters behind the plane mirror. So the object distance and image distance is equal. Okay. Now, what is the second characteristics? The size of the object is equal to the size of image. Means if the person is 4 feet tall or 5 feet tall, so the size of image will be 5 feet. But for this condition, your mirror should be large enough. Means to see our full body. What is the size of mirror? Half of the our body. Means suppose there is a 1 meter tall person and he want to see full body in mirror. So the size of mirror should be half of the length of the person. Means if he is 1 meter tall, so the size of the mirror should be minimum 1/2 meter to see his full body image. Okay. Now there are two characteristics we have learned. The first one is size of object is equal to size of image. The distance of object is equal to distance of image. Okay. And one thing, if you raise your hand, right hand, so your left hand will be raised in the image. So this is called laterally inverted. So the plane mirror form laterally inverted image. Now, okay, and image is erect, means the image formed by the plane mirror is erect. Means if you are standing like this, your image will not be inverted. Suppose you are standing like this, means your mouth is up. So in your image, your also mouth is up. Your it does not like this, means your mouth will goes like this. Suppose you stand like this, so it will not form your image like this. Means this image is called erect. Means what is erect? Upside is upside and downside is downside. And what is inverted? This is inverted. Inverted is upside is down and downside is up. So, but plane mirror form erect image. Erect image. Okay. And the another characteristics of the image formed by the plane mirror is the image form is virtual. What is virtual image? Virtual image is the image formed inside the mirror or behind the mirror. That is called virtual image. And virtual images also can be defined as the image that cannot be formed on the screen. Okay. Okay. My one question. Tell me. if a person is moving with 5 meter per second towards the mirror, okay, person is moving 5 meter to meter per second towards the mirror, so what will be the velocity of the image approaching towards the means back side of the mirror? What will be the velocity of the image if the person is moving 5 meters per second towards the mirror? So what will be the velocity of the image? Okay, Hemlata Sharma, 7b can answer. 7c, okay, 7c. Harshika,
sir, 5 meter.
5 meter, okay, very good. And one thing more, relative velocity. So what is relative velocity? The speed of image or velocity of image is also 5 meter per second. Relative velocity is when when two things moving in opposite direction, this object is moving in this direction, suppose each direction, and what is the direction of this object? That is west. So in relative velocity, what we do, we just add up. If the object and image moving in opposite direction, means both the things are moving in opposite direction, so the relative velocity is 5 + 5, 10 meter per second. I think you have not learned yet about the relative velocity, but in higher classes you will learn. I'm just giving an idea of the relative velocity. When two things coming in opposite direction, we just add the velocity to get the relative velocity. Okay, so don't worry about it. Okay, and I have discussed about the regular reflection and irregular reflection. I have shown you that PowerPoint presentation of regular and irregular reflection. What happens in regular reflection? In regular reflection occurs in highly polished surface or shiny surface. That's like mirror or new furniture. Okay. So the reflection takes place from mirror, still water. What is the still water? The water at rest. Still water means rest water. Okay. That is not moving. So the reflection from mirror, still water or oil or highly polished surface or metals or furnitures is called regular reflection. Okay. And you can see in regular reflection, all the reflected ray moves in a same direction. This is a polished surface. When light rays fall, what happens? All reflected rays moves in a same direction. This is incident ray and this is reflected ray. But what about irregular reflection? Irregular reflection is also called diffuse reflection or irregular reflection. So irregular reflection occurs on rough surface. What is rough surface? Just like this blackboard, the wall, the stones. Okay. So when light rays come, it goes in different directions. Some here. Okay. Suppose some coming here. So they can go here. So the direction of reflected rays are different, are not in the same direction. And that occurs on the rough surface. Rough surface. Okay. And that is called irregular reflection or diffuse reflection. Okay, now tell me, the reflection from the mirror and the reflection from the irregular surface, from the rough surface, in which reflection the light is scattered more? Means the light is scattered more. Who will tell me? In which type of reflection, regular or irregular, light scattered more? Okay, Harshika Agarwal, Ankit Singh, and Aditi, 7D. Okay, Aditi, you tell me. Aditi, she's not responding. Okay, leave her. Okay, Niharika, you tell me.
Sir, in regular inflection.
Regular. Okay. See, student. Okay, Ankita, you tell. You know the answer.
Sir, it is irregular reflection.
Regular?
No, sir. Irregular. Okay. Reflection.
So, see, light scatters more in irregular reflection. You can see, in regular reflection, it occurs from highly surface. So, all the reflected rays go in the same direction. means it goes in the same direction. And what happens in irregular? It goes in different direction, means it scatters. Okay, so scattering of light occur more in irregular or diffuse reflection, that in from the rough surface. Okay, so all the things which are visible to us due to the irregular reflection, means if we make the room with the mirror only, and we light a LED or CFL that is fitted in our room, tube light. So if the room is made up of mirror instead of walls, what happened? The light will reflect it only in one direction. Okay, and in regular reflection, due to regular reflection, what happens? It causes strain to our eye because all the light rays coming directly towards us. So it causes strain to our eyes. Okay. So that is clear that scattering more occurs in regular reflection. Now we will understand reflecting periscope. What happens in reflecting periscope? Reflecting periscope is like this. There are two mirrors fitted here. Okay. Okay, it is used in war, means when there is a war between two countries or some fight. So they use reflecting periscope to see the things by hiding. See what happened. Suppose this is a plane mirror. Okay, plane mirror is fitted here. Light ray will come. Okay, and it will get reflected from this mirror. Then it will get reflected from this mirror. Okay, and what happened? It form an image here, and from here a person can see thing. Suppose this is hilly area, means here it is covered, and we want to see from the hilly area. Suppose we see by our eyes and we got shot in our head, what happens? The army or the one soldier will get die. So they use reflecting periscope. They just raise the reflecting periscope from the hiding area, and from here if someone is there, some enemy is there, the image will form from this mirror, and then from this mirror, and they can see here. Means they will put the reflecting periscope here. Okay, and if the enemy is in front of this periscope, what happens? The image will form on first here, then from this mirror, this downward mirror, and from here the soldier can see if there is enemy or not. Okay, suppose there is an enemy here. So what happened? Image will form first from this mirror, then from this mirror. So the soldier can see, yes, there is the enemy. So they will prepare for it. Okay. And what is the disadvantage of reflecting mirror? If there is a tube-like structure, so there is chances of getting a dust settled here. If the dust or anything, sand or soil, gets settled on the mirror, it will form blur image. Because if your mirror is get dirty, you can't see your face clearly. Okay, now difference between real and virtual image. I have told you that image formed by the mirror is virtual image, and virtual image cannot form on a screen. Okay, so we have categorized, we have experimented two things. Okay, so we have seen that there are two images, that is formed behind the mirror or inside the mirror. So we have named it what? Virtual image. And the image form on the screen, like that we go to the movie theaters and we see with the help of projector. You have also in your smart class fitted in your classroom. So what you see that with the help of projector, a light ray is coming, a light ray come, and it goes on the screen, white screen, and it form a image. Okay, so in movie theaters, what happens? With the help of projector, light rays goes, like projector here, light rays goes and form an image on a screen. And that image is called real image. Okay. And real image is inverted. Inverted means if the thing is like this, the image will form like this. But we fit something in a projector or the device so that the image gets converted into erect shape. Means the inverted image converted into erect one. Okay. Now, this is all about the difference between real image and virtual image. Okay. And virtual image is laterally inverted. Laterally inverted means if you raise your left hand, the image will be of your right hand. If you write letter L like this, image will be like this. Yes, your homework is you have to find the in alphabet, means from A to Z, that which letter is miss which letter have image as same as object. Just like I'm giving you example, the image of O is same as O. Okay, just like you have to find the letters from A to Z, means the image of O will be same. If you put letter O in front of mirror, the image will be like this. Means the object and image is same. So you have to find the letters of it between A to Z out of 26 alphabet, which letter and image is same. Now, use of plane mirror. They are used as a looking glass. Means when we want to get ready, go to party, or when we come to the school, we used to see our face in the mirror. Okay, they are used by the barbers. When we go for haircut, barbers use the plane mirror. Okay, they are used for signaling the scouts and army personnel. Okay, plane mirror is used to reflect things. So they used to reflect and give us signal. Okay, they are used by the opticians to provide false dimension when their place of work is very small. Okay, see here. Optician is one who makes the lens of your eyes. Means if you can't see clearly, many of the students have wear specs because they can't see clearly. So when they go to the opticians, they check the power of your eyes and they fit a letters. Okay, letters, and they say to you, read that. And the letters are like that, A, B, C, and then again small letters. Then they increase the distance so they can find out the how much power you need, and they make the lens for your specs. Okay, so opticians use the plane mirror as a false dimension. Means what is the false dimension? See, suppose you are sitting here, okay, and their office or their means where the opticians work, is the place is very small. So what happens? They hang the chart of A, B, C, D here. Suppose there is a chart A, B, C, D, and it is suppose 5 meters from you. Okay, 5 meters from you. And where is the image formed? Image will be formed. Here is plane mirror. Okay, suppose here is a plane mirror. So the plane mirror will form 5 meters behind the mirror. If they will keep the mirror here, so what happened? The letter will be formed big. The letter will form big. Suppose if we keep mirror away from us, our sight means our image is small. If the size of mirror is small, if we place it away from it, so we can see full body. If we place the mirror in just here, towards our face, what happened? We will see large image. So they put the mirror here, and due to the movement of the mirror, the letter size will increase and decrease. So they use as for false dimension. Okay, as it is in jewelry shops, what they do? They use multiple mirrors. Means they use too many mirrors. Okay, just lower your hand, please. They use too many mirrors to form multiple images. When you go to the jewelry shop, sometimes you see there are so many jewelries. It is not like that. They use just mirrors. Means they use mirror so that one jewelry is, if there is a one jewelry, the image will be formed 2, 3, 4 due to the too many mirrors. They use multiple mirrors, so the image will be multiple. So you that will looks attractive. Okay, and they also fit mirror towards the necklace, so that if the necklace or ring is small, so with the help of mirror they can the size will be increased. You try at your home. Okay, just stand in front of mirror, okay, and go towards the mirror just like this. Like this camera, if I put this chalk here, you can see image of the chalk or size of chalk is this. If I move this chalk here, what you can see? Size is increasing. Just like you do experiment at home in front of plane mirror. Okay, so in the jewelry shop, they fit a the plane mirror in such a way that if the small ring is there, the side will look like this big side. If the small necklace, a small jewelry, the side will look big. Okay, they are used in solar cookers. How they solar cooker use? Suppose this is a solar cooker here, solar cooker is fitted, and this is the plane mirror. What happens if the sun shines? All the rays will go here on this plane mirror, and this plane mirror will reflect all the light towards the mirror. So all the rays will collected here, and the cooker will get heated, and we want to use to make anything or cook anything, we can move cook with the help of solar cooker. Now they are used in making toys like kaleidoscope. You have used the toys like kaleidoscope like this, and you see when you rotate the beautiful formation means like 3D things, means just like thing. Suppose things will increase just like here, and they will decrease just like here, means presentation, or we can say themes. So in kaleidoscope, the mirror is fitted. When you rotate the kaleidoscope, you can see the things is moving like this, zigzag, zigzag, zigzag. Okay. They are used in making reflecting periscope. We have discussed about the reflecting periscope that is used in war condition. Now, if you have any doubt, you may ask. Ankit Singh, class section C. Yes, Ankit Singh. Ankit Singh. He's not asking. Okay, Niharika.
Hello. Thank you.
Yes, Ankit.
Sir, why the W is not opposite image form? Why
okay,
W?
You to tell me another day. It is your homework. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Niharika, you tell me what is your doubt.
So, can you give the one example of regular reflection and irregular reflection?
Yes, see here. Suppose this is a mirror, okay? When we light a torch or something is a source of light, anything, torch, mobile flash, anything. When the light falls, what happened? All the light goes in the same direction. Okay. You can do experiment at your home. Just take a plane mirror and on the flashlight of torch, what you will do? What you will see? All the lights will go in the same direction. Okay. Sometimes when we sit in us in winter time, when we sit in our roofs to get sunlight, what happens? We take a mirror, a small mirror, and we used to take reflect the light towards our friends or anything. What happens? Sometimes when we wear a watch, and light is coming, what we do? We do reflect like a watch, and all the light which goes in our friend side. We used to do disturb our friend. Just like, when you use plane mirror in the front of light, you can reflect all the light in one direction. Suppose take a plane mirror and light is coming from tube light or any bulb. You take a plane mirror and you can reflect all the light towards any direction. Because when you rotate the mirror, the angle of incidence change and the angle of reflection also change. Did you understand about the regular reflection?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see for the irregular reflection. This board, the classroom, all are irregular reflection. Occurs irregular reflection because they are rough surface. They are not shiny surface. When we light a torch or flashlight, what happens? It doesn't reflect in all directions. The light gets scattered. You can see here. If I light a torch here, what happens? It gets reflected?
No, sir.
It gets scattered. You can see it gets scattered. If there is a mirror here, it reflects towards any direction. Okay? Did yes, you understand?
Sir. Yes, sir.
You try at your home also. Okay?
Yes. Okay, sir.
Okay. Thank if you sir. Have any doubt, students, if you have any doubt or something.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, Abhinav.
Sir, please give the example of angle of incidence.
Angle of incidence?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see the recording class. Angle of incidence is nothing that if the light rays fall on us anything, suppose this is a mirror and this is light fall and this is normal imaginary line. This is the angle of incidence. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, everyone.